Compulsive hoarder Seymour moved into his house in Philadelphia after a contentious divorce 13 years ago. He set up home upstairs and opened his medical practice downstairs.
I'm Seymour. I'm a retired orthopedic surgeon. That was my passion. That was who I was. I have a degree in medicine. I also have a pharmacy degree, which I completed before the medical degree. This is the doctor's office. These are the medical records of some of the patients. When I ran my office, it didn't look like this. It was clear. I had three secretaries. And over here is one of the examining rooms. If you took a picture of me operating, you'd probably see a big smile on my face. But I can't do anything right now because of my diabetes and my limited vision. And my hand shakes. And it's the end of the road. This is my house, living room, storage area. This is like the graveyard of all the junk I have. Nothing in here is that important anymore. A couple of things that may have been important to me at one time, but aren't now. This is Franklin Mint die-cast cars. They were collectible, and they have all movable parts. That's why they're interesting. This is a 1907 race car. I have probably, 40, 50. It just accumulates. My kitchen is a disaster. A lot of it's not being used right now because of the situation. But there's a commercial coffee grinder. It's a slicer, stainless steel slicer, which I used to use it all. But not right now. I enjoy cooking, but I can't cook in here because if I turn around the pot, there's visitors in the pot.
My father is a hoarder. I think he started collecting right when he moved in. It's not livable. It's completely unsanitary, unhealthy, disgusting.
The bathroom's a little bit of a mess. Everything works in here, but if it didn't have the bugs, I'd be much more comfortable here.
My kids have been trying to get me to take care of it for a couple of years. I always resisted. When they started to push, I just basically turned them off.
But Seymour will not be able to avoid responsibility for these dire living conditions any longer. He's received a complaint about the property, and he's asked daughter Jessica to read the letter to him.
Hey, Dad.
Come in.
They have in here that an infestation of insects, rodents, and vermin or other pets have been found at this property. Mm-hmm. The structure must be promptly exterminated by processes that will not be injurious to human health. They know about the roaches. So They know about them. Mm-hmm. They want to come in here. If they come in here and see all these bugs in here, they're going to kick you out. They're going to condemn this place, and the city typically gives 30 days for you to get out. So I want you to know that we have to move forward.
Yeah.
This is all just stuff.
Right.
Okay, and besides the fact that it's getting in the way of you living your life.
Mm-hmm.
And it sounds harsh, but this is like, it's like you're dead. I mean, it sounds terrible, but
I know.
I don't see you. I only talk to you on the phone. You can't hold my daughter. You can't do anything. You're not even part of my life. If you don't go through with this, my hands are tied.
Jessica is prepared to take on the gruesome task of clearing up the clutter, but not without a little help from her family.
I have not been in his house for, I don't even know, at least 5 years.
I'm Sarah. I'm Seymour's daughter-in-law. And unfortunately, because my husband has started a brand new job, he couldn't be here today. I came in his place. The last time I was in Seymour's home was approximately 7 years ago. I haven't been over here in 7 years because the last time that he visited me, he gave me a full cockroach infestation in my home. And based on that, I knew that his home was in an unsanitary place that I didn't want to take my family into.
Oh, this is far worse than I imagined. This is shocking. I had no idea it was like this. Is all this black stuff roach feces?
I think so.
Sir, welcome to Philadelphia.
How are you?
Not doing too well.
Yeah,
watch
can
the
see that.
Hi, Bennett.
Hi, Seymour.
Do you sleep with these bugs crawling on you?
Well, try to keep them off me.
Why don't you pull out the spice rack? Because I want them to see how bad it is.
Yeah.
Come on, we're here. It's all cards out on the table,
well,
Dad.
The spice rack is what I had
built
here.
Go ahead, pull it out.
She doesn't like it because it's...
full with bugs?
Oh, my God.
Oh. Disgusting. Oh, my God, what is...
Oh, my goodness. The cockroaches just fell down. It was just unbelievable.
I'm getting a headache just standing in here breathing this air.
Really?
There's roach feces, there's roaches, this stuff has bacteria, it's hazardous. Yeah. I'm nervous about even breathing
trashed.
This air. I don't even know what this has done to your health.
I was completely overwhelmed and unprepared for what I saw. I just can't believe somebody so brilliant that had a fantastic career, fantastic life, is living like this. It's just sad. It's just really sad.
This is more than we can handle. You know, there's a lot of people's lives that are affected by this, not just yours. Your relationships with the grandchildren are hanging in the balance. Your relationships with us, it's gotta stop.
I know.
It stops now, okay?
Love you.
And we all love you, and we're all worried.
Take care.
Okay?
Thanks for coming.
You're welcome.
Bennett?
Oh, my God. Disgusting.
I'm upset. It really is very depressing. They're disgusted by what they see, and looking at it through their eyes, I can see that.